Hello everyone. Today I wanted to take a video on how to do correlation in Neoload. But before then, I want to introduce what is a session ID or a session identifier. Welcome to Little's Law, and this is your Vasant Shanmugam. Today we are going to see about session ID in this video. What is a session ID or a session identifier? Session ID or a session identifier are unique, short-lived numbers that servers assign to users when they log in or visit a website. The servers will then remember or track the users for the duration of their session. How does the session IDs work? Servers use session IDs to remember the users because the underlying protocols are stateless. And once they receive session ID from the server, user send it back in the following request to identify themselves. For example, when we log into a website, the server assigns us a session ID and sends it to your browser wrapped in a cookie. The browser automatically sends the cookie back in the subsequent request to the server, so the server knows who is making the request. There are some features for the session IDs. Let's see them one by one. First, uniqueness. Session IDs must be unique across all the users. Otherwise, it will end in a disaster. The second feature is timeout. Session IDs have best by date or they time out after a certain period. If they don't, a hacker could steal and use them indefinitely. Generally, the expiry period ranges from minutes to weeks. High-risk applications expire session IDs more frequently than the low-risk ones to minimize the attack window. Can you guess the third feature? Yes, guessable. Session IDs are not and should not be easily guessable. A bad example would be an algorithm that generates sequential session IDs. Hackers can easily identify the patterns and hijack the user's sessions. Now let's see the three different ways session IDs are generated. First, random session ID. These random session IDs have no meaning by virtue of being completely random. The server sends the user to the client and stores them in a database along with the user information. Second, session IDs using shared secret. This type of session IDs are created in such a way that the information needed to identify a user is embedded into the session ID itself. Since session IDs are self-contained, the server does not need to store them. Let's see an example. We combine the username plus the IP address with the client's secret, mostly a secret key. And the format would be like the username with the IP address and a secret key. Here, when a request arrives, it contains the username and IP address, which is automatically recorded. The server then uses the username, the IP address, and the secret key to regenerate the session ID and see if it matches the session ID passed by the client. If it matches, the verification is successful. Third, random session IDs with predictable path. Here there is a slight modification of the random session ID generation method. The session ID contains a random number and a hash combining some properties of the user, such as the username and the IP address. For example, it contains the user ID plus the IP address with some random number. The resulting session is stored in the session store and looked up for each request. And this is more secure than using a random number. Let's see some of the security best practices when it comes to session IDs. First, don't send session IDs unencrypted. Use HTTPS to encrypt all traffic end to end. Second, don't send session IDs as URL parameters, which are visible in logs and it will be revealed by the users inadvertently. Thanks for watching the video. In our next video, we will see what is correlation and how do we do it using Neoload. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button. Thank you.